Go.
Team Secrets, turn to pick.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the regional qualifiers. And it is Europe that we are following, the Boston Major. And we are having a matchup between Team Secret and Na'Vi. And I'm sitting here together with Fog. We have the pleasure of commentating this match. Should be hype.
This one should be hype, but I feel like it might be a little anticlimactic, unfortunately.
You're thinking it's going to be one-sided in favor of Team Secret, correct?
Yes. They've been looking pretty hot lately. Na'Vi's been seeming like they have a few issues. I think the one game that we saw where they just kind of steamrolled Alliance was probably one of their better showings recently, but they do seem to be struggling a little bit.
That was also Alliance drafting very greedily. That was 2 days ago or something. So
very greedy Alliance draft, and Alliance didn't really play so hot.
Yeah. So Team Secret they're basically the only team, I think, that plays Bounty Hunter.
Yep.
So first ban Bounty Hunter normally would be uncommon to see that, but since it's Secret, that's understandable. We also have an IO Sand King and an OD ban. All those three are fairly normal. Oh, hello.
Ooh, Na'Vi's been talking.
Na'Vi has a plan.
Yeah, they have a plan for sure. I like that they're going back toward the Earth Spirit. The hero's been kind of falling out of favor, but Sineko's pretty beastly on it. And the Batrider Earth Spirit's a combo that we used to see for a while. You know, the dual, they put like the dual kind of aggro thing. Or Sineko can just run around and make space anywhere. But General Batrider, talked about it throughout, what, TI, Manila, everything. This guy is probably one of the best Batriders in the world. In the laning phase, he somehow always manages to get double kills and stuff. Like, he's extremely impressive on it. And his Sand King is actually really good too, but it seems like his Sand King was not doing so well lately, but either way, Secret banned it out, so.
Yeah. Well, General's bad. Like, solid.
Yeah.
Very, very, very solid. Keeper of the Light is good against Earth Spirit.
Yes.
Did you just say that, or did I?
Oh, no, I didn't
okay,
say that.
Sorry.
I do like the Coddle versus Earth Spirit in general. I think Coddle's just a very... He can be very bad versus, like, every hero, but he can also be very good versus every hero if it's played in a proper manner. Which these guys probably play it one of the best. I mean, Puppy and Pie are pretty legendary Coddle players.
Yeah. Juggernaut picked up as well there, and I mean, both drafts fairly unusual with the Coddle and the Earth Spirit picked up, but the Juggernaut and the Batrider are comfort heroes for both teams.
Yep.
And they don't reveal too much about what they're going to do. What do you know about the aggressive tri-lone situation for these two teams? Do they prefer it? Do they avoid it?
I think that these teams actually tend to avoid it. I think Secret does do the dual lanes, but I feel like every time I've seen them do the dual lanes or whatever, it's with Puppy playing Bounty Hunter, and that's just kind of, it is what it is, you know, it's a Bounty Hunter, you're just being obnoxious. The quick ban coming out.
Yeah, compared to previous game, I mean, Na'Vi hasn't even dipped into their bonus time here at all.
Yeah, Timber, a very annoying hero, pretty sure that, Secret played it a few times, not too much actually, but they didn't want to. I don't think Na'Vi wants to play versus it anyway. That hero can be annoying as hell, especially with Coddle getting the Chakram with the double Whirling Death. Just massive damage potential.
Yeah, I like the Warlock ban as well. We saw yesterday how successful it was for Alliance. Sorry, was that yesterday? We saw how successful it was for Escape.
Escape
on
was 2 days
Tuesday.
Ago.
Tuesday.
Everything's
all
big.
Yeah. All games are blended into one, but a very successful hero, I think, anyway. A hero that we're going to see a lot more of these qualifiers, and Shadow Demon removed as well. Annoying hero, is all.
Yeah, just a strong, obnoxious hero, easy to rotate with, and wow, that's a very early Sven pickup, but it's great versus Juggernaut in majority of favors. The Warcry is always good. Jug is pretty much pure physical besides Blade Fury.
Yeah, it's surprising to see Sven picked up so early. It really makes me think that Na'Vi has got like this specific plan that they're going for.
Yeah, it does. It really does seem like that. They've got a lot of lockdown already on their heroes. They're already believing a lot. But okay, Ogre picked up, so that was one that we saw was banned first two in the last series because Imperial plays it like every single game.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, this Ogre hero is falling into a very high fashion apparently. It's been drafted like first two a lot of the time, but.
Yeah.
This is the first time I've seen it on Radiant in the last week, at least. From the games I've seen.
Yeah, we've seen it be very successful on on the Dire side so far.
Yeah.
Reserve time. Overall, though, with the Juggernaut, it pairs up nicely. It's still very strong with Lane Harass, and Bloodlust is strong as ever.
Maybe Na'Vi banned the Timbersaw and the Lifestealer because they can do pretty well versus Batrider in like a 1v1, and they want to give General a like the best advantage you possibly can. Lifestealer is pretty annoying. Batrider is pretty hard to play versus Lifestealer if they just rage off and run at you pretty early in the laning phase.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is the first of the Na'Vi sticking into their bonus time, so perhaps...
Invoker. Yeah, they're completely switching things up from what we've been seeing, at least recently. They haven't actually played too much, actually. I was taking a look. I thought they'd played more. They've only played, like, 10 matches total in the past month, and they have picked zero Invoker during that time. Only one Sven, which they won with, and a couple Batrider games, but...
Yeah, general Batrider. I think Batrider's also, or rather offlaners, there's a little bit of a smaller pool that you pick from lately.
Yeah, but it looks like Na'Vi definitely, I think after the games yesterday and stuff, the other day, they had a talk and they were like, okay guys, like let's just go toward our comfort instead of like all these meta heroes, I guess, quote-unquote meta heroes. This patch is a patch where you can pick pretty much anything as long as you play it in the proper manner.
And let's be real, Zendi is never gonna perform bad on an Invoker.
No,
right?
Definitely not. And they have a lot of setup now for it too. It's Cold Snap with Earth Spirit rolling in is very nice in the laning phase too. It gives your Invoker a little bit of leeway. And yeah, like the Sven stun, Lasso, Earth Spirit stun, all decent setups for Sunstrike. And it permeates through Blade Fury, which can always be nice for Juggernaut.
Okay, so talk to me about Tidehunter.
I think Secret's one of the few teams that still really like Tidehunter. It's been seeing a little bit more Tidehunter stuff, but...
Forev plays it, right?
Yeah, Forev plays it. And he's... I mean, Forev's an animal, actually. I'm watching his stream, that guy's so freaking good. If you want to learn Dota, watch... If you want to learn stuff about high-tier Dota, watch Forev for sure. But Tidehunter... it's going to be really hard for Na'Vi to actually kill that with a Sven or Spirit. They haven't shown their third support, but Tidehunter should be able to contest pretty well, especially if there's an Ogre. So maybe this is where we're going to see Secret go for some type of dual lanes and just moving around to cause a little bit of a ruckus on Na'Vi's short lane.
Just looking for the mid one hero. It's a Templar Assassin that gets removed. Mid one used to be famed for his Invoker, so that one's no longer an option here. What do you like to play up against an Invoker in mid?
I feel like I keep seeing mid one playing like the Storm, the Embers and stuff. Probably not the best this game versus Earth Spirit, Sven, Invoker, Batrider because of how much disable there is.
Yeah.
What else does mid one really like? He actually has a massive hero pool, so it's pretty hard to determine. Okay, so they do go for the Storm anyway.
Yeah.
I just feel like they love this because it's... I don't know, just maybe one of the strongest heroes. It benefits from Bloodlust. He just likes it a lot. Why not? If he's super confident.
It works for them, and I think if he gets the right backup in terms of supports, he should be okay.
Interesting. Frosta ban from Secret, too. So they were like, alright, Na'Vi needs something else to maybe accelerate their Roshan and Tower push besides the Sven and the Invoker. So the Frosta ban. I know Artstyle used to play it a bit. One of the few that picked it up still.
Well, one more hero to go. Bonus time used.
Versus Storm and Jug.
They love their jungle heroes and their rotating heroes, but Earth Spirit is already a hero that can very well rotate mid and help out Dendi in that mid lane.
Artstyle loves his Chens, his Enchantress. Yeah. Those are his big two most favorable, I'd say, but... since they do have the Earth Spirit, maybe he'll go for something different. But every time I've said that, actually, they picked one of the two heroes I've said. So I'm just going to stick with the Chandra Enchantress.
Well, maybe it's going to be a bigger curveball. Enigma.
I haven't seen that hero in ages.
No, exactly.
That's one of the few.
I mean, it's also a jungle hero, but it's not as aggressive in the early game. And Arcel really likes to be aggressive in the early game. So it really depends on how active they're planning, like you said, how active they're planning to be with that Earth Spirit. And how much control they want to have to give Sven over the lane. And, of course, if they're expecting a dual lane from the Tidehunter.
Ooh.
Or if they're expecting just a solo Tidehunter or not. And it will be a silencer there, so...
It's great synergy with the Batrider. Something that... It's like a combo that we've seen many times from lots of teams. But didn't really expect that one to come out of Na'Vi. But Na'Vi is complete... They completely changed up their plan from what we've seen in the last, like... couple weeks at least. They're going back to their comfort, and I feel like this should look pretty good for Na'Vi. I think the draft is fairly even, but I like that Na'Vi's going back to what, you know, what they like. But they do have a pretty hard game set for them. It's a Sven and Invoker as their two core heroes versus the Storm Jug. Just that matchup in general is a little bit tough because the Storm and the Jug are going to be benefiting from Bloodlust the entire time.
Last player to be killed before the GG is called.
What? Wait, is that before the GG is called? Oh, just the last person to die, right?
Last person to die.
Oi.
Pilot die? Why not?
Why not? I have no idea.
Will a tower be killed before 10 minutes? Not with this lineup.
I don't think either team should get a tower kill. Maybe Secret if the offlane gets like crushed.
Hold that thought!
Uh-oh.
Jira. There's a Gush available. There's not enough range.
He skilled the Gush right away too. So what? This is an aggro.
Yeah.
More than the likely. He even has boots.
Total number of Roshan kills.
That one could be a couple.
Three? Two.
Two's pricey. 0-2 seems like such a safe one.
Total number of smoke gank kills at
game
end.
What kind of questions are these? 13? The game has to go forever for 13.
Well, it depends on if you get 5 kills above 1 smoke gank.
True. I don't know.
We're going to gamble.
Oh, you Sheever.
We're going to be... Yeah,
why not?
Why not?
So... really quick looking at the warding actually situations, just because we didn't really talk about that at all the last game. Level 1 TP by Earth Spirit, puts one down there. Batrider, I think, TP'd as well. Blocked the hard camp with the sentry and put a vision ward. And then the
Radiant.
Secret side puts one to block the pull camp. So they're doing like a pseudo dual lane like we were mentioning, and Puppy's just kind of run around wherever he feels relevant.
The mid one will be up in the mid lane against Dendi's Invoker. Storm versus Invoker. On the offlane, we have Forev on his Tidehunter, supported by Pilot Eye's Keeper of the Light, with Arts down the Jira there, and actually they're gonna go
right
in.
Away.
Sunstrike already, won't it? That's for
oh, you put Puppy for your prediction.
No?
No, you didn't. You put Pi, didn't you?
Yeah, but it was Pilot Eye. They just...
Oh, well, I guess...
They're just
okay.
Bad. Because it's just wrong.
Yep. Well, so much for that one, Sheever. Good job.
What? No. No, that's not the achievement. It's gonna get updated every time one person dies. And this is wrong too, because it wasn't Puppy that died.
Last one to be killed, because he hasn't died. So he... Oh, whatever.
Last player to be killed. And it was Pilot Eye that died. I don't know
how this works.
Thanks,
whatever. Yeah, no idea. Great. But Na'Vi, no hesitation though. That was sick. Like, instantly they just went on him.
Yeah, talking about people going on people, General has to run away here from MP. Well, how do you feel about the Juggernaut matchup against the Batrider?
You can spin off the Sticky, sure, but I think Batrider overall can win this matchup just because you're able to spam him down. You can't spin off every single one of the Sticky stacks. You should be able to farm pretty well. But I think it'll be fairly even, still. I think maybe it's a little bit Bat-favored until Jug gets some levels.
Okay. Not for a while. Well, I gotta say, Puppy's been setting mid for a while, but he's going, he's going back mid. Gets his Bloodlust to mid one.
Yep, that was the one thing I was gonna be a little worried about, is if, where Sindeko is gonna run around, but he should definitely just sit around mid lane, because, yeah, the Ogre is gonna be staying there too, so it's gonna be a semi-duo lane mid.
Yeah, and the supports will be the ones keeping control over those runes.
Mid one with 10-3 CS to the Dendi only 4-0 right now, so the Bloodlust is really helping mid one right now.
He had 9 of the Sticky Napalm stack. That's crazy.
Yeah.
And, luckily he has a magic stick, so he can use it to get a spin-off still, but... Wow, that is some scary stuff right now, and we do have Puppy rotating bottom, so...
General
the dual
lane
mid
out.
Is not there anymore for mid one. Oh, hello.
Uh-oh.
This seems like a very difficult lane for Secret here on the
Pi's
offlane.
In trouble here.
Oh, he was looking for the stun. He has got the stun. Gets a double stun with that as well.
Oh, they might actually get Forev here as well.
Yeah, why not? Anchor Smash still comes out, but it doesn't matter.
He doesn't have how am I just derping right now? He doesn't have his W with Kraken Shell. Yeah, he doesn't have Kraken Shell. He doesn't have a Stout Shield, anything. So he actually takes a lot of damage from right clicks.
Yeah.
Brain lag right there for a moment.
That's okay. It is still early. Fairly early.
Fairly
oh,
early.
Shit!
Oh no! The overlay. Oh god.
Overlay. Sorry. Well, we're casting mostly for in-game viewers.
Oops. 733 people are gonna be pretty upset for 3 minutes.
Yeah. For 3 minutes. My bad. Do you see how I say my bad while actually it's only Pixel saying it?
Yeah.
It's good.
Whoops. Ah! It's the morning!
It's
the morning.
It's so early.
So MP is doing fairly well. General as well. He moved he moved back down as soon as Puppy moved. He touched pressuring. Typical general things. But mid one. Look at this mid lane. 24-3 to the 10-5 of Dendi.
How is this possible?
Bloodlust. He gets like an extra auto attack every single time, so he's able to last hit easier. The rage is coming. They're trapped in a cage.
But it's only 3 minutes, guys. And I'm very happy that downstairs are actually commentating off of Dota TV, so we don't see it at all. Although we just said it out loud. Well, I'm not gonna type that it will be fake. They saw it.
Oh, Pi again.
Pi is having a very, very bad time. 0-3-0.
That's a lot of int. I think Silencer's got an int every single time.
Yeah.
So that Coddle is probably sitting really low.
I think that's one of the sad things, that we can't see how much intellect he actually lost.
He's lost. He's 3 deaths, so all 3 of those he's definitely lost.
Yes, but there's like no thing saying that. So he has lost 6 intellect.
-6.
Sad life.
Oh well.
There's nothing to be doing. Nothing to be done about it now. Oh. It's unfortunate. It really is. But on the bright side, we've had it. It's not going to happen again.
Yep.
So
just remember, guys, there is a 5-minute delay for these games. So typing T-Taurus about the overlay. We noticed it a couple minutes ago. It's happened. Yeah. Yes. Whatever.
We even noticed it before the T-Taurus went on.
No, we did.
I think that's pretty admirable.
We noticed it only 3 minutes late, not 5.
Yeah. Ooh. Pick the cave. Okay. So Pilot Die, I think, has made the smart decision. Like, okay, for Ev, there's experience coming into the tower. You take all of that as Juggernaut dies on mid, but we're not following Juggernaut, we're following mid one who is not dying to creep. Never
mind. Wait, what?
Juggernaut died. Sunstrike. Invoker got the kill.
What? I guess he was holding the stick, his stick, trying to, like, big play general and just get Sunstrike. Alright.
Yep.
That's
what you get.
Pretty huge, actually.
Ow. I hear myself. That's awkward. It was very loud all of a sudden.
Yeah.
I wonder if we can turn that up later on. Okay, so... So who's winning this laning site?
Definitely Na'Vi.
Definitely Na'Vi.
Yeah. Mid one's doing very well, and I think he actually has stacks. I think Puppy was stacking in the jungle for the Storm Spirit, it looks like.
So you're saying that Na'Vi's winning despite mid one doing amazingly well?
Yes, definitely. They have 5 kills, I mean.
It is not all about the kills. I mean, even if you look at the net worth, there's a Storm that's like on top. I do see the other three cores being
Na'Vi. Experience is pretty large, and having your silencer get that much free int this early is pretty sweet.
And even if it is a support silencer.
And Artstyle is one of those players, though, that always ends up having, like, when his enchantments and stuff, it's like, oh, Dragonlass Aghanims, you know, etc., etc. So.
Yeah. Don't worry, we fixed it.
Now we get yelled at by Owen,
and
gods, and
No, it was Owen's fault to begin with, remember?
It was Owen's fault to begin with,
Easy. It's soon.
So?
I will just say soon. Soon! Okay. General is doing fairly well in this offlane. We'll go for the Blink Dagger.
Obviously, yeah, he's doing great.
He has the gold for it.
This is like more than what you'd want. That Sunstrike kill actually put him in a very good position. Yeah.
So,
he's pressuring MP so hard, sticky.
So in terms of making rotations, so far we've seen only the supports rotate in and out. At what point are we going to see a difference in that?
I think that we should be seeing right now. As you say it, makes the first move.
Yeah, mid one makes the first move. Let's see if it's a successful one. It definitely is, and he gives a kill to MP as well. With the one hit only slash.
Yeah, I mean, whatever. That was kind of a spite right there. He's like, killed me, I kill you!
Yeah, don't worry, the overlay is about to disappear. It's all good. It's all good. Okay.
So,
the mid one rotates first. Denny as an invoker is not gonna rotate anytime soon.
Yeah, they're just putting him in jungle and giving Sinnoh levels in mid lane.
And he does need to rotate, he has Sunstrike to help out. So that is enough on that one. And Forev, well, Forev is a little bit sad. He does have a Ravage, doesn't carry a TP scroll. Which is something that if this was a pub, he would probably get flavor for it.
Yeah, I'm really liking the way Navi's looking right now, though. The Sven is pretty much in like even ties with the Storm Spirit, and the Invoker is a bit ahead of the Juggernaut, even though they weren't laning in that manner, but still.
Yeah, well, mid one rotating bottom again. MP has got a spin available if they just have anything to stop him. But they didn't skill Vortex, they didn't skill the Fire Blast. No disables! Oh, Courier. Uh-oh, I don't think that Snake who can... Maybe he can.
Boarding mission.
Oh, he's going in. He's going for Puppy. Has got some backup there as well, Sunstrike. Will hit. Couple of hits needed. The Silence is there as well. And in comes Batrider and Dendi just in case they're needed. But Sunako will be getting the last punch in first. This thing is so wrong.
It's because they haven't... it's the last person to die after... like, the last person to have a death, I think. I think that's how it works. So it's updating saying that that guy hasn't died yet. Because everybody else has died. So now it's if mid one dies, it's going to say somebody else's name.
Oh, well, then we completely misunderstood.
I don't know. Oh, there's a global coming out.
I think that's for top lane, saving Forev. That's what they want to do. Maybe get a kill over turn as well. But did Jirak get the stun in before mid one can get the zip off of Olive Style?
Oh,
he goes a
Ravage.
Very nicely done. Forev has to be careful, though. He's very low. But did Jirak? He gets Vortex. There it is. That level one Vortex. Value there. Lasso. Blinding Light helping out. Did Jirak not able to hit mid one anymore if he were to go for that one. General flying out. He has still got his Firefly, but Omni Slash from MP, who has to run back through fire. Oh, Healing Ward has to run back through fire.
Oh man,
he's fine.
Such
Zeus.
Low Zeus.
Why is Zeus not picked anymore lately? Like, never. Almost.
Too many nerfs. Static field nerf. Too many bulk.
But he's still fairly successful in pub.
Yeah. I don't know. He just doesn't really do much. He just kind of stands there mid and farms, right? He just
farms.
Invoker can Sunstrike all the... that's from level 1. And he actually scales very, very hard because he's at least a fat, like has the physical aspect.
I guess so.
Straight magic. And it's a core. Like, that Zeus core with just no physical whatsoever is painful.
That's what I think is pretty sad, actually. Fair enough. But in those situations, wouldn't you love to have the Zeus or an injured operation? Yeah. I guess Denny with the Sunstrike could have tried, but he already had it used, so...
Yeah, he was just off the mark of getting one of them, but mid one, with his nice rotation so far, has actually made a lot of work, but unfortunately, he actually hasn't picked up a single kill from them, which I definitely think that they should have tried to give him one of those last hits, but...
I'm not too sad with MP getting two of them, though. He needed them, too. He was not doing all too well, now he's second on last hits. Second on net worth, rather. So it looks like we have got a bit of a gathering coming out here from Navi, perhaps. Very nobody nice. On top lane, top lane anymore. Did you claiming the entrance?
Yep. And it looks like... so we had a tower not before 10 minutes. So it was the tower at 12-minute mark, first one that goes down. And General actually opted to go for a stat build rather than go for that blink build on the Batrider. At least for now. He probably bought them as he was dying.
Yeah. 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 I mean, he's still fairly far off, and I think he finds that, you know, there's no rush. There's still not a team that wants to initiate. Even if he would have a Blink Dagger, he would still not be able to do more than what the Nurse Spirit already can by himself in terms of initiation, if they want to go for the initiation. So far, he's been getting those lassos off quite decently.
Yeah, he definitely wants it, though, because they have the combo with the Silencer and everything with the Spania. Yeah, he definitely will, I mean, get it eventually. But maybe he'll go for the drama if he's dying again. He doesn't want to keep getting delayed on his items, but...
Not for his sake, I hope he doesn't have to.
Yeah. I think they probably need that flank build to go for a tower push to get that pick off into the pressure, but... Perev recovered very well after that kind of disaster start in the top lane. He actually has his mech finished up.
Yeah.
And now they're just farming the ancients, which were stacked up by Pi and Puppy, and Pi is able to just always Chakra the Tidehunter and the Storm throughout the he squished and a very strange death. That.
I mean, we saw him sitting in the jungle. And apparently he was just waiting for the moment someone to show up by himself. No creeps around, Omni Slash, and he dies.
Yeah, that's I don't think Sonico really expected him to be there at all.
Nope. I don't think anybody was expecting him to be there. Is it worth missing out on quite a bit of farm just sitting in a jungle waiting for a kill?
Dire's bottom tower. Hey, why not, right?
Why not?
MP is one of those players that likes to go for kills over the farm, right? He's very aggressive. And yeah, I mean, why not, right? Getting a kill with your Omni Slash is always efficient.
Oh, there's a Ravage up. They find General. In comes the Ignite. Gush there as well, but they
That's too deep.
Do.
Yeah, they know.
There's too many people that can come in with a tier 1 tower still up.
Quick to turn, though. I like that. The secret, like, right away they identified. Right after the Gush, I'll be like, let's not do this. Not
and in terms of, in comparison to what we saw with other teams, like, they're on the same page.
Yeah, definitely.
It gets a call like, okay, we're back, and nobody hesitates. Everybody just goes back, knows what to do, or knows what not to do, rather.
Yep, that's two towers now for Secret. They have, like, this mech thing is like the last game as well. Group up on the mech timing and go. And Na'Vi doesn't have a mech carrier for quite a long time. No one who's a natural in mech carrier, at least. You can maybe get one on, like, the Silencer or the Earth Spirit, but that's not, like, a Tide Hunter or a Dark Tier.
There's a courier, actually. Oh, didn't bring his item. Well, that's a shame. That's all.
Na'Vi can't really fight into this, though. They're afraid of the Ravage mech. They're just going for this split pressure.
Well, they get a tower. Oh, I was going to say they're going to get a tower in return, but Secret doesn't want to have any of that. They'll defend that tier 1 bottom just fine. This is the right thing to do if you're Na'Vi, though. We saw in the previous game what it could bring if you do try to fight into that.
Yeah,
how it can just ruin your game.
Very scary, though. After General was having a pretty decent laning phase, now he's just having nothing and Ditch a Rock caught in a, with nothing.
Yeah,
nowhere
I
to
mean,
go.
He gets a stun off, but I don't think that matters at all. It's a mid one. Global Silence coming out. That's from Na'Vi, and I feel like that was miscommunication 101. If it was there earlier, I think DJ Rock could have maybe lived. Or at least could have bought more time for the team to come in, but with the Global Silence coming out at that time.
I don't know, that's...
That's a question mark.
Dichira was super far up by himself with nobody even close to him. Yeah, I don't know.
They have no vision there either. Let's see if they can catch Poppy though. General really wants it. He gets Omni Slash the moment that he shows though, and it's enough for the kill because it is level 2 Omni Slash.
And the Sun Strikes off the mark, and Forev claims a tower by himself here. Oh man, all sorts of disaster for Na'Vi.
I mean, after the draft, we said Na'Vi's lineup, you know, look pretty solid, but just the team play coming together for Team Secret is, it's just showing, for now, the better team, the better plan, rather. They have a plan, they stick to it, they know what to do.
Yeah, Puppy's just a walking bloodlust, pretty much, honestly.
Yeah.
He really is. He
doesn't even spec his last stun, it's max bloodlust. Bloodlust everybody that he sees, and it's working out.
Yeah, it's working great.
That's why your first pick, Ogre.
Probably have like what a 5 or 6k, maybe a little bit higher net worth lead right now.
Oh, that's sentry ward.
But yeah, Na'Vi's. It's 16 minutes in, and I feel like they're almost trapped in their base at this point.
Yeah, look at that gold graph. A little bit of a problem there. I'm waiting for mid 1 to decide he's waited long enough and zips in on someone, but we'll see if that happens.
Yeah, they're just going to group up and go for another tower now, too. They're like, alright, Na'Vi's on their side of the map pretty much completely except for General, so we'll just take the enemy jungle, farm it all out, take towers. There's... Na'Vi need to... I don't know, they need to try to get some pickoffs and stuff, but Secret's not really giving them the opportunity. They're sticking together. And now they have the blink on Tidehunter, too.
In the meantime, General, finally. Ta-da!
Yay!
17 minutes into the game, after having a laning stage that wasn't actually too bad. They even got a kill on MP.
Yeah, it was
fairly late one there.
Couple deaths just really set him back hardcore, and they haven't been able to really pressure towers too well with their lineup. They got the one bottom now, but now I feel like this is a desperation.
That's a deny even. That tier one bottom. So they lose a tier two top on Na'Vi. I do believe that Na'Vi should be aware that something like this is going on. They had the ward over there. They They saw them pass over here earlier.
Well, they're actually gonna get it for free. Uncontested completely, that's great. I mean, it's not...
That's a win.
It's not what's gonna win them the game, but it's you know, small steps, baby steps.
It will give them a better chance at a high ground defense when it comes, because I don't believe that is too far off. Maybe after this tier 2 tower. Still yeah. Last one standing on the side of Na'Vi.
We'll probably see Secret just wait the Aegis out, honestly. They can just farm and not really be too worried. Look, even Pi's prepping for this game to go into a later fashion, prepping for that Aghanim's, which is ridiculous on Coddle.
Yeah, that's crazy, actually. And since Puppy's only a walking Bloodlust, he doesn't need items, so he can just spend his money on wards and stuff.
Yep, he's like, alright, I got my raindrop, that's all the mana regen I need.
I say that, but Pi still buys the wards as well.
Yeah.
Because Puppy earlier had like 1,000 gold.
Oh, there we go. He bought a full hood. Okay, so he's gonna go for the pipe.
Ooh. Yeah. Oh, it's useful. They can deal better with the Earth Spirit. Oh, hello, Minwan. The silence stop and a little bit of trouble, and he has to deny himself. Yeah, last player to be killed. Well, that's a very. It was Dendi. That's a very difficult description, I think.
I kind of understood it, but...
Then the last one to be killed, but there's no detection, and he would actually be killed if they just had detection. Even the Illuminate almost was enough to kill him, man.
Yeah, he went for the Yule's build, too. So a bit of a change-up, we haven't seen that too much lately, actually. He's just like what the Drom, Aghanim, Bot, Midas.
Well, it seems like Team Secret has full map control.
That's great really... item build from MP. I love the Diffusal versus the Silencer and everything.
Yeah.
You can end versus Earth Spirit. You remove the global from yourself and even your teammates if you need to.
Long zip in from mid one after he died earlier on. Want to go for the Jira, the target to get, the spend, the core, the carry of Na'Vi drops down. Has an Aegis. Where is his team? Needs some backup. There's a Ravage available as well. People would come and help him out. He does get only slashed and slowed down, and there is nothing.
Yeah, I say that they maybe didn't want to fight into the Aegis, but they don't even... They have no concerns of what Na'Vi's... They actually don't care.
And Na'Vi didn't seem to have any answer for that either. There's just Arxel standing on the high ground. We'll get picked up as well, and they'll just move forward to get the tower as well. In the meantime, Dendi, all he can do is... He didn't go back to base after almost dying in mid lane. He went to bottom lane. He's now too low to fight. Would have to get back to his fountain first before doing anything at all. And General also is like, okay, you know, I abandoned my base. I'll just try to farm something.
This doesn't... They had great... Like, the first few minutes, Na'Vi looked like they were coordinating very well, but now it's like everyone's just doing their own thing. It looks like there's complete disconnection.
Should they be doing anything? Like,
I mean, they can't just lose the game. They're losing Braxis right now, and they're sitting at tier 2s trying to set up for a kill.
Is this what?
But now they can't even.
Okay, now they're teleporting. They were hoping that someone would teleport to defend, but really, are you going to defend a tier 2 when you have a chance of getting a melee Rax? Or two sets of Rax even on this bottom, on this top lane? Oh, there's a global silence. The lasso as well on the Juggernaut. And in comes the Ravage in just a second. It is a full 5-man Ravage. Very nicely done by Forev there as Sven is in too deep. Ends up dropping. The rest of Na'Vi is already getting back to the fountain while the racks are falling down. GG's cold, that is it. 22 minutes. Well, this is turning into a pretty fast series of games here. I think we might need to wait a little bit for the next one even.
Seneca left without even saying anything either. It seems like there might have been
Ouch.
Something not going too well with Na'Vi there that game.
This was their first series as well for the qualifiers. Of course, you are watching.